Hi, welcome back to Daily Dose of Rust. So today we are going to do something spectacular. In the previous video, we took a look at how to use the declarative macro in Rust. As you know, there are two types of macro in Rust: the declarative macro and then the procedural macro. And we gave an example, detailed example, in two videos. One was how to automatically generate multiple functions by simply calling a macro, which is a declarative macro. And then the other was how to generate a struct and then generate getters and setters for the struct, including the fields, by simply calling a declarative macro, which you've created. Please take a look at the first video and then the second video in this series. Now, in this video, we're going to take a look at the other part of macros in Rust, which is the procedural macro, specifically the derived macro. There are three types of procedural macro in Rust. We have the derived macro, which you are going to look at in this video. We have the function-like macro and then the attribute-like macro. Now, in this video, we are going to give you a full example on how to automatically implement a thread for a struct by using a derived macro instead of having to do that manually every single time. And as a reminder, procedural macros do not accept a pattern and then generate a code just like declarative macro. Rather, they accept a code and then modify it at compile time. And that is simply what we are going to do. We are going to be able to do something like this, just like we do for the debug thread. If you want to implement the debug thread automatically for a type, a struct or an enum, you simply do it this way. In this video, we're going to find out how to do the same thing for this custom thread we have here. Okay, so let's get started. Remember to like the video and then subscribe so that you get notified when we release new video. Okay, now let's say we are building a game and we have a thread called can talk, so that all our characters can talk, but we are creating a crate that will allow anyone to implement this thread. Now, naturally, what people will do is you have a struct and then you implement the can talk thread for the struct, and then they can override the method. It's all good and fine because there is just one method to override. But what if there are more? Our users will now have to write an implementation for jump, run, and throw, and that will take a lot of time. But there is a simple way of doing this. We already know that we can easily implement the debug thread for any struct by simply doing this. So by simply doing this, whoever is using our crate will no longer have to implement the debug thread for this person's struct. Now, why can't we do something like that for can talk, so that we can come in here and do the same thing this way? But right now we can't, because it's saying cannot find derived macro can talk in this scope. So this is what derived macros help us do in Rust. It helps us to accept a code and then modify it. So in this case, what this is doing is accept this person struct and then implement a particular thread for it and then return the code at compile time. But when we are using it, all we have to do is just to add this macro, right? So let's create an own macro so that our users don't need to do this. So let's limit it to one method. Now, the first step is to create a procedural macro create. Remember that we have a binary create, a library create, and then a procedural macro create. So let's create the create. We make it a library. As a convention, after typing the name of the create, if it's going to be a derived macro create, you end it with underscore derive. Now, it's important to understand that the only way to create, right now in Rust, the only way to create a derived macro is to create it in a separate crate. It's not like a declarative macro where you can create anywhere, as we saw in the previous video. So it must be created in a separate crate, and that is why we are creating a separate library crate for it. So now the crate is created. Over here, you can see the crate can talk derive, but right now it's not yet a procedural macro crate. We have to open the cargo.toml file, and then in here we add the lib section and then indicate that this will be a procedural macro create by setting this to true. Then next we add our dependencies. First, we are going to need the send create and then the quote create. The send create will help us convert our Rust code into an AST, abstract syntax token, so that we can modify it and then the quote will help us convert it back to a token stream that Rust can then compile back. So step 3, we go back to the libs.rs file, then we use the pro-macro derive attribute to give our macro a name. Right now we're calling it canTalk. Then we declare a function. As a convention, we also add the keyword derive at the end. Now each macro function will accept a token stream as the input and also return a token stream as the output. A token is the smallest part of a Rust code. Now a token stream is like a sequence of tokens. So while Rust is compiling our code, it will accept a series of this token as a token stream. Work on it by implementing the canTalk interface automatically and then return back the token stream for us to continue its compilation process. So next we import the token stream from ProMacro. It comes with Rust, so we don't need to add it as a dependency. Then we import the sim create and then the quote create. Now using the sim create, we obtain the abstract syntax tree from this input stream. We can modify it directly, so we have to obtain the abstract syntax tree so that we can modify it. Now the abstract syntax tree looks something like this. Okay, so the syn create allows us to convert our code to something like this, okay, which is the abstract syntax tree, and then once we modify it, we then use the quote macro to convert this to an input back to a token stream so that it can now be compiled again. You can see that this identifier will represent the struct's name, and then you have the data. Okay, this says it is a struct, and then you have the fields that you have inside there and all that. This makes it possible for us to pass and modify Rust code at compile time and be able to inject other features that we need to. So it will look something like this. Then we get the AST, we use the same macro, and then we'll pass the input, and then we'll unwrap it. This way, if an error occurs, it will propagate it up. Now there are three kinds of error that could occur here, and remember that this will occur at compile time. So it's either you get a compile time error, or the code will panic at compile time, or if the macro is running infinitely, the compilation will just hang. Now the first thing we need to do is to get the name of the struct or enum that we want to implement it from. Since we now have the abstract syntax tree, we can easily get that. We can just say num, we read that from the AST. Now we have that name, we can now generate the implementation and then return it. We'll now use the quote macro inside the quote create. We wrap everything inside here, and then in here we do the implementation. Since it's going to be called talk, that is what we are going to do here. Implement canTalk thread for whatever the name is. We use this hashtag to access the name. And then we implement the talk associator function. For now, let's just print something to the terminal. Great, we have to convert this back to a token stream and then return it. We can just say gen.into. Now that way we are done. Now we have a macro called canTalk that we can use this way. Now next, let's list this canTalk macro that we've just created in the cargo.toml file for the main.rs create. Since it is local, now all we have to do is to declare the canTalk derive create as a dependency by providing the path, since it is local to our project. Now back here, we can then import it. Great, now we can do this, something like this. Next, we can now use it here. The same way we are able to do this. In order to test it, let's try calling that associator function on person, even though we've not implemented it manually here. Now when we run our code, we get now talking, and that comes from this talk associator function being invoked. So this way we are now able to create our own derived macro that will allow anyone implement this canTalk thread without doing it physically. And this is the beauty of derived macro, which is one type of procedural macro in Rust. It can accept a code and then modify it and then return back the code. which is exactly what we are about to do here. Now in the next video, we will take a look at the other types of procedural macro, which will be the function like macro and then the attribute like macro. Remember to like the video and subscribe so that you get notified when we release more videos.